ओके
हेलो, वेलकम टू आवर वीडियो. सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू टेल यू अबाउट द फेमस पर्सनालिटीज इन रशियन एम्पायर इन द 18th सेंचुरी. माई सेल्फ ऋतुजा साखरकर.
आई एम ऋतुजा मांडरे.
आई एम सेजल सिंह राणा.
एंड माई नेम इज मुकुल शर्मा. So today we are going to discuss about the famous personality, one of the most famous personality of Russia, and a famous emperor, Peter the First. Peter the First, he was the one of the Russia's greatest statesmen, Peter the Great, and he was the Tsar and the first emperor of Russia. He was a man who was unwilling willpower and he was a extraordinary energy and supervisions person. He was having inherited a vast background in his state, and he ruled and power a great employing and systems. He was born in 1672 in Moscow, and further he was the future emperor, and he was the son of the Tsar Alexis the First. His mother was Natalia Naryshkina, and he was the second wife of the Tsar. And Peter was his mother's first son, but he was his father's 14th children. So this was a great competition for him to prove himself. Now Natalia, we are going to discuss about his works. In late February in 1725, he ruled the Tsardom of the Russia and later the Russian Empire from 7th May of 1782. And till his death, he joined the ruling before 1696, and his elder half brother Ivan the Fifth. Through the number of successful wars, he expanded the Tsar and into much larger empire, and he made his ruling one of the major power of Europe. Before this, Russia was under the Asia Pacific, and after him he revolutionized the whole criteria, and he also laid the groundwork of Imperial Russia Navy after capturing the post of the Azores and the Baltic Seas. He led the cultural revolution that replaced some of the traditional and the medieval schools and politician systems in one of the modern scientific and Western influenced, and he made the Enlightenment in the basis of European countries. He visited the many countries in Europe to get ideas related the infrastructure and many systems. Peter reforms had a last impact, largest impact and lasting impact on the Russia and many institutions of the Russian government. His thinking was related to the democracy. He was one of the first ruler who used to think that democracy and the people rule must be established, and he was known as the founder of development of city of Saint Petersburg, and which remained the capital of Russia in 1917. He got lots of name. He awarded lots of name, like by the grace of God, the one of the most lovable person, and somehow he had both bad and good thinkings related to his treasures. But he was named after his the portraits, and he describes the newborn by his good health, and he was one of the good healthed baby of the Tsar, because his for one he was his other 14 children were not that good in the health, so he was one of the capable to achieve the settings of the Tsars. Peter, and he in his region he developed the the thinkings of the peoples. He wants to revolutionize the living of the people. He was the one of the he was the ruler who made the beer tax, because in the people in Russia he was they think that the beard is a good for as a thinking of Asian, but to make and look them elite, he brought it this tax. He was his main goals was related to make the proper development, and in 1697 he travels in the European and Ottoman cities to make new places, like he used to fake his name so people not make him special, and he can easily understand the development in the European cities. And he visited the Australian and the Austrian cities, and after coming back to the Russian Empire, he worked on that and made a great city as. So thanks for hearing me.
So I am going to talk about the great Katrina II. Recognized worldwide as a noteworthy historical figure, Katrina the Great was one of the most prominent rulers and a deserving administrator character for Russia. During his reign, which was from 1762 to 1796, she expanded the territory of the Russian Empire. Sofia Frederica Ostaka was born in Germany in the city of settling in Persian Pomeranian, 2nd May 1729, in the family of Christian Augustus. Sofia was married to Peter Frederick, the nephew of Elizabeth, where she was converted to Orthodoxy and given the name Katrina. She was a woman of great talent, intelligence, and ambition. Her strong and masculine mind, so eager to learn, had been trained and developed with all the learning and accomplishments of the age. On 28 June 1762, with the aid of her lover, Grigor Orlov, she raided the troops of St. Petersburg to her support and declared herself as the Katrina II, the sovereign ruler of Russia. During her early reign, that is from 1962 to 1964, she ruled over the domestic and the foreign policies of Russia. But during her first years, she was more concerned over strengthening her position in the Russian Empire. Katrina's government followed a general policy in which she developed confidence among the public with the aim of leading Russia as the full and equal participation in the European government. She proposed a system providing equal protection to all the persons under the law and enforced prevention of criminal acts with dignity rather than harsh punishments. Katrina attempted to expand the Russia's power at the expense of its weaker neighbors, which were Poland and the Ottoman empires. In 1772, Augusta and Russia annexed Polish in the participation war, and hence Katrina concluded peace with Turks. In 1787, the Sultan family of the Turkey declared war against Russia. As according to the past centuries, the Russia won the war, but they took over four years for completing the war and declaring it to the empire. From this, they got the Black Sea of the coast from the empire. Another one of the Katrina's court was the domestic concern was the elementary of the economic strength. During her reign, St. Petersburg became a major cultural center of the Russia. In 1787, she founded the Society for the Translation of Foreign Books in Russia. Her army and the fell temporary call of her, the Katrina II the Great, she won over 78 victories, strengthening Russia's participation in the European government. Thank you.
So today I'm going to tell you about Ivan Kulibin. Ivan Kulibin was born in 10 April 1735 and died in 30 July 1818. Ivan Kulibin was a Russian inventor whose name has become synonymous with self-taught inventors and people keen on the mechanics and or engineering. Kulibin was born into a mechanics family in the town, in a merchant family in the town of the Nizhny Novgorod. A local psalmist taught him to read, write, and count. His father, Pyotr Kulibin, wanted him to become a merchant, but Ivan Kulibin was more interested in mechanics. Pyotr Kulibin did not approve of his son's unusual hobby, as mechanics had nothing to do with flow trading. Once while in Moscow, Kulibin bought some tools for Nizhny Novgorod for the clockmaking. There was no clockmakers in the Nizhny Novgorod, and the Kulibin willingly became one. After mastering the necessary skills and gaining a good reputation among the two citizens, he decided to make a special clock to present to the Empress Catherine II. When the Empress arrived in the Nizhny Novgorod in 1767, the clock has not been completed yet, but Kulibin showed her his other crafts, a microscope, two telescopes, and an electric engine. Catherine was impressed. The clock Kulibin presented it to Empress was really one of a kind. Its mechanic consisted of the 27 parts, and it was in the shape of a goose egg with a mechanical theater inside. Every hour, the egg opened, and small mechanical figures inside performed reconstructions sent from the Bible. An angel descended to the holy sepulcher. The clock is only a one piece of the Kulibin works, which has not been lost. Now it can be seen in the state of the Hermitage in the St. Petersburg. He was assigned to the head of the workshop of the Academy of the Science. In 1772, Kulibin read in the newspaper that the British government was offering a prize to design a single span bridge. Kulibin was not only the Russian inspired by the newspaper advertisement, but he had at least two rivals, and both of them failed. Kulibin walked across the bridge and himself and invited all the workers and witnesses to join him. The project was success. In 1779, Kulibin designed what can be called as a searchlight. In 1791, Kulibin made the acquaintance of the young officer named Nefistin, who had lost his leg in the Russian-Turkish war. In 1791, he made the prosthetic leg for Valerian Zubov. In 1791, Kulibin designed a foot-powered cart, which could be considered the prototype of an automobile. In 1793, he designed an elevator for the Winter Palace. In 1801, Kulibin quit his job in academy and returned into his hometown. At the end of his life, he became obsessed by the idea of the Preptum mobile. He spent all of his money attempting to build one, but at the end he died in poverty. Thank you.
So I'm going to tell you about Mikhail Lomonosov. Mikhail Lomonosov was a Russian scientist, poet, geologist, and astronomer who is also believed to have influenced the formation of the modern Russian literature. His expertise in diverse fields earned him the title of becoming the first scientist naturalist from Russia to have gained international acclaim. Born into a family of peasants, he was urged to pursue the family business from a young age. However, his passion to study led him to Moscow, Kiev, and later to Germany. Upon his return to Russia, he began his teaching career at the St. Petersburg Academy of Sciences. Alongside, he made several independent discoveries like the determination of freezing temperature of mercury, definition of the law of mass conservation, atmosphere around planet Venus, explanation of the phenomena of icebergs, and understanding gravity from a mechanical perspective. He was an advocate of progress in domestic education and was responsible for the establishment of the first Russian chemical laboratory at the St. Petersburg Academy of Sciences. He also co-founded the Moscow University. A linguistic reformer, he was known to have set the foundation for Russian literature. Other than writing poems and books, he also composed plays that were all appreciated. He was elected as Secretary of State in 1764. However, he could serve in the position only for a year. About his childhood and early life. Mikhail Lomonosov was born on 8th of November 1711 in Russia to Vasily Dorofeyevich Lomonosov. He belonged to a family of coast-dwelling peasants called Pomori. At the age of 10, he began assisting his father in his cod fishing and cargo business. During this period, he also pursued education in Russian German. He was issued a passport in 1730, and in order to continue his studies, he traveled to Moscow. After some time, he was inducted into the Slavic Greek Latin Academy. In 1736, he received a scholarship from St. Petersburg Academy and continued his education at the Imperial Academy of Science in St. Petersburg. The following year, he, along with a few fellow students, was chosen to study at the University of Marburg in Germany. About his career, Mikhail Lomonosov came back to Russia in 1741 and commenced research and work under Professor Amin at the St. Petersburg Academy of Science. A short while later, he was made adjutant professor of physics at the Academy Department. In 1745, he was inducted into the chemistry of St. Petersburg Academy of Science as full-time professor. The same year, he published a catalog of more than 3,000 minerals. In 1748, he published his work, Short Guide to Rhetoric. In 1751, St. Petersburg Academy published the debut collection of poems of Mikhail Lomonosov. In 1752, he released his poem titled On the Utility of Class, along with composing his second play, Demophon. He was keen to improve the quality of education in Russia, and in 1755, he, along with Count Ivan Ivanovich Shuvalov, established the Moscow University. In 1761, he made an observation of planet Venus and its orbit around the sun from an observatory near his house in St. Petersburg. His observation led to the hypothesis regarding the existence of atmosphere around the planet. He developed an updated model of a reflecting telescope that allowed viewers to look at the image with an eyepiece without any obstruction. He presented the model at the Russian Academy of Science. However, the type of telescope was published much later. In 1764, he was appointed as the Secretary of State. About his major works, Mikhail Lomonosov was an expert in diverse fields such as geology, physics, and chemistry. He gave much importance to the development of education system in Russia. He died of pneumonia on 4th of April 1765 at his residence in St. Petersburg, Russia, at the age of 53. Trivia. In his honor, the Moscow State University was renamed as the M.V. Lomonosov Moscow State University in 1940. An underwater ridge in the Arctic Ocean was named after him as the Lomonosov Ridge in 1948. The USSR Academy of Sciences awarded the Lomonosov Gold Medal for achievements in humanities and natural sciences. The medal was named in honor of Mikhail Lomonosov. From 1967, the Academy awards two medals, one to a Russian national and another to a foreign scientist. A crater on the moon as well as a crater on planet Mars have been named after Mikhail Lomonosov. Thank you for listening.